Hi everyone, this is Nick, and today I'm gonna try to make a diverging stacked bar chart to represent some visitor experience survey data that I have. This is just dummy data, but it's very similar to the data that I work with in my normal life when I work in research and evaluation for zoos and aquariums. So these are 10 different items that we would ask our visitors to rate after their experience, and we have this fully labeled scale, not at all, slightly, moderately, very, and extremely, and then different aspects of their visit to rate, things like how easy was it to see the animals? How welcoming did you feel like the atmosphere was, etc. A stacked bar chart like this is a really common way to visualize survey ratings like this. We would call these like Likert scale or Likert type items. This isn't exactly a Likert scale, but it's a Likert type sort of item when you have that sort of matrix of rating items that you ask people to respond to. And this is a common visualization, but it can get a little bit cluttered and a little bit difficult to sort of read for people. And one way that we can make this a little bit clearer is by diverging the bars. So we pick a middle point, and in this case, I'm going to pick the point between moderately and very, because I want to know how many, you know, what are the items that are rated best and worst in terms of that very and extremely rating combined. So I've already colored the chart here, so it's pretty nice. So you can kind of get a sense of the varies and extremelys really easily. These are in the blue, and the not at all through moderately are different shades of orange. But I want to see if I can diverge this, and I want to see if I can do it right inside of PowerPoint. So I haven't done this yet, so this is going to be a walkthrough, and I might make mistakes. So good luck to all of us. Okay, we're going to hop over here to the slide. In my chart, since I built it in PowerPoint, all I need to do is right-click to edit the data, and the source data file, that Excel file, will pop up on the screen. Now what I want to do is I want it to diverge at this zero point on the x-axis. So I want everything that I want, every value that I want to the left of that diverging point needs to be a negative value. So I can actually open this chart right here by clicking on this little icon that says Edit Data in Microsoft Excel. When I open that, it's actually going to give me a full Excel sheet, and I can use it with all the functionality that Excel has. So what the first thing that I want to do is turn all of these values from not at all to moderately. I want to turn them negative. So to do that in a really quick way, I'm just going to type down here in a random cell -1, and I'm going to copy it. So that -1 is now on the clipboard. I'm going to go ahead and highlight all the values that I want to be negative. I'm going to click on Paste Special right here. And then I'm going to go to the operation menu right here and say multiply. So this is going to multiply all those values by -1, turning all of the values into negative values really quickly. So click OK, and now they're negative values. I'm going to go ahead and click that percentage sign. Okay, let's close out of this and see what it did to my chart. Ah, perfect. Now you can see we're getting the bones of that diverging stacked bar chart here. So except I need to play with this a little bit. So my y-axis labels here are inside the middle. I want those to be on the far left. So you have to highlight that, click that here, go over to the format axis menu, and then what you're going to do under labels, we are going to go to label position here. See how it says next to axis? We want it to switch position to low. So I'm going to go ahead and do low like that. And I think that looks good. I might actually just update the x-axis line to be a little bit thicker so that it becomes a little prominent, maybe 2.5. And we'll close out of that so you can see it. You can see it looks really nice. You get a really nice sense of what's on the left side and what is on the right side. Now the thing is, I have this axis down here from -40 to +100. I probably don't need that anymore. And it's also kind of weird and misleading because of those negative values. So we can actually keep it, but let's go ahead and see, let's update it and see what would happen if I update the minimum to -1.0. You can see it kind of gets a little bit more squished. And I think that could be okay, but we might just put it back to that negative 0.4. I think that looks a little bit better. It fills the slide a little bit better, but I don't want them to be negative values because it's not as if these are negative values here. So what we have to do that is update the custom number format. So go down to number, and then under here it says percentage. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to, under format code, it says 0 and then a percentage sign. That just shows a normal percentage sign. If I do a colon, a semicolon, and then another 0 and a percent, that's basically saying how I want PowerPoint to treat the negative values. And since I don't have a negative sign in front of the 0, it's going to make those, all of those values positive along the x-axis that's there right now. So let's go ahead and click on add, And you can see now that it's updated my values to all positive values from that 0 to 40 and then 0 to 100 on that scale. If I wanted to keep this scale like this, I think I could do that. Now, the similar thing, if I wanted to directly label my bars, I would click on right click and then add labels. But unfortunately, you can still see that those are now negative values too. Same thing, I'm just going to go back over to that bar chart menu. Number, and then under the format, we're going to click on percentage here. Let's see if that works. Yep. And then I'm going to make sure that there's zero decimal points, so it's just like this. And then again, under format code, I'm going to do the semicolon and then zero and percentage sign. And that tells PowerPoint how I want it to treat the negative values. I want to turn them positive. So we're going to go ahead and say add. Perfect. And now that is a way that you could label those values there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to delete the x-axis. I really don't need it because I'm going to label most of the things here. Now something that's really interesting that I see is that the way Excel did this, or the way PowerPoint and Excel did this together, is it actually put the moderately category on the very end, and then the slightly is in the middle, and then the not at all is here closest to the diverging line. We actually want that to be opposite. So all I need to do here is with the chart selected, go up to select data. The select data source menu is going to pop up right here, and what I need to do is just reorder some of these things. So what I'm going to do is extremely, let's see, not at all here is at the end, but I'm probably going to put it into the middle because it looks like it's treating it just a little bit strange. So we'll do that, and then moderately, slightly, let's see, we're going to put slightly down one to see if it looks like that, and there it goes. It looks like it did exactly potentially what I wanted it to do. But it also messed up the legend. So what I have to do, I'm just going to delete the legend and we'll get rid of that. But you can now see that that lighter orange is the moderately, and then we have the slightly and then the not at all right there. Now, if I wanted to make my own legend, I would probably do that just with text boxes. I think that's really the easiest thing to do here. So we'll do not at all. And then let's see, we'll duplicate that. Make sure that's kind of aligned right there. I'm just going to call this slightly. Oops. Moderately. Control. I'm just pushing Control D here, and that duplicates the text box. Very. And Control D again, and then extremely. Now, if I wanted to make sure that these were all nicely aligned, I'm just going to go ahead and select all of them. Go up to the Arrange tools. Let's go ahead and just distribute them horizontally. And you can see it kind of works, but not really because they're all right aligned. Let's see if we left, if we center them. That looks a little bit better. I'm going to go ahead and make this the darkest shade of orange, a lighter shade of orange, and then the lightest shade of orange right here. And then our very looks pretty nice. So I would kind of do something like that. If you wanted to insert boxes, you could do that too. So that's a nice way. There's also some ordering that you could do here to kind of order things from greatest to least, and I like to do that on the back end as well. So let's just go ahead and order it so that the most positive responses are at the top and the least positive responses are at the bottom. So let's go ahead and again open our Excel data source, right click and edit data. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to calculate a field over here to the right. I'm going to leave one column space so that it doesn't automatically add a new series to my chart. But I'm going to call this, let's see, I'm going to call this top two. And I'm going to say equals sum, and then I'm going to sum the varies and extremelys. And then I'm going to put that down. So now you can see these are the combination of the top two box. Now what I want this to be, I want to sort this so that the lowest value is at the top and the highest value is at the bottom, because we know that Excel does things in reverse. So whatever I have in my Excel data source, it's going to show up in reverse in my chart. Very confusing, Excel. I hope they change that someday. So I'm going to copy this whole series here, right click, and then click on sort. And it doesn't look like I have anything open. I think I'm going to have to open it in the full Excel sheet. So go ahead and click on that icon. And now with this selected, I'm going to right click again. Now the sort tab still doesn't look like it is available to me. Let's see what I can do here. I think because this is an Excel table, I'm not able to do it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change this from an Excel table to just the data range. So highlight the whole thing that is an Excel table, go up to the table design tab right here, and then click on convert to range. That will make it so that the dynamic table is no longer there in Excel, and it's just a series of data in your spreadsheet. Click yes. Now let's see if we can sort this whole value here. Right click and sort. There we go. And I'm going to say sort by that column H. We're going to do smallest to largest. Looks good. Let's close out of this and see what it did to my chart. Perfect. Now I would label these labels here. Let's go ahead and have white those labels. We're going to say inside end. I like to make sure that those labels are set to inside each of the diverging ends. I think it gives a nice aesthetic feel to that, and it's easier for your eye to sort of look at that label. Let's see, and then we'll position that inside end. Perfect. A really nice diverging stacked bar here. And now it's really easy at a glance just to see, like, oh, the most positively rated items are safety. The least positively rated items are, it was easy to see animals. So maybe now this gives us an idea of where we need to sort of spend our time in terms of improving our visitor experience at our zoo or aquarium. You could do this for other data that has nothing to do with zoos and aquariums, any sort of survey data this would work for, and a diverging stacked bar chart is a really good way to do that. If you like this video, I hope you will give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and tap the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a new tutorial in data design, PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Remember, you don't have to be a professional designer to look like one with the software that you already use every single day. I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you next time.